repeat, and I am in the GF gym room with my brand new GF Strat 6334 SSS Stratocaster. I finished it a couple days ago, but that guitar is awesome. It's something what I would like to talk to you about it, how those knobs, pickups, how they work. I am using custom-made EMG pickups. They are single coil pickups with a high impedance. They have, I think, close to 7K, like 6.8, 6.9 kilo-ohms. And they are comparable to any another high impedance pickup. I tested them with the Seymour Duncan, with the DiMarzio. They basically, with the volume output, they are comparable. With tone optionality, they are out of box. Such a beautiful tone control, that's unbelievable. So that guitar has a toggle switch. Toggle switch is set up to 5 position, exactly same like on any Stratocaster. Neck and middle, only middle, bridge and a neck, only bridge. It has a volume knob. The volume control is active from the middle, where is the volume on the maximum, to the minimum when you close it up. From the middle, the maximum, there is a notch in the middle of the volume control, so you can feel it. You don't have to look at it. You feel when it's in maximum classical volume. So that's only that neck pickup working right now. When you go over the middle position, it works like equalizer. It tunes that neck pickup with those two or one of those anode coils to resonant frequencies. So listen it. I will go from the maximum right now. Let me get back on the neck pickup. I was on the bridge pickup, sorry. So neck pickup. Right now it's just in the volume control, is in the middle. It's only neck pickup. Now I will hit it. And you are tuning the tone. Basically, the coils are tuning with the capacitors. This pick up the maximum performance. So, volume knob. Close. Up to the half, where is the notch, is the volume. After notch, variability of the tone. So basically, that master volume and master tone, I don't call it tone control, I call it like a tone shifter. It's like shifting the different variances of the tones. So it'll be better to call it tone shifter. Somebody call it phase shifter, but basically it's not a phase shifter. Here is another knob for the phase shifting, so I will explain you later. So that tone, that master tone with the phase shifter, it's working in any position of the toggle switch, with any pickups, and with any another adjustments. So volume and phase shift, tone shifter knob. The second knob is designated knob only for the bridge pickup. It has a notch in the middle. So right now I am in the position when bridge pickup should work. And it's not working. The notch in the middle is the volume. When you open it, you open the volume in phase with one or two anode pickups. This is in phase. From the middle position, when you close it, this coil is out of phase with one or two anode pickups. Out of phase, in phase. You cannot hear the difference. If you are using only one coil and turning the coil in phase or out of phase, basically you don't hear any difference because you don't have another coil turned on to compare in or out of phase with another source of signal, with another pickup coil. So what I am going to do right now, I just put those two coils together. We are on the position number two, so bridge and neck is together. Tone shifter is it's out. It's that volume part is in the middle, maximum volume, master tone is in the middle, and I will show you how the tone shifter works. If that tone for the volume knob in and out of phase is in the middle position, only that pickup is working. Now I add it in phase, the bridge pickup. Out, and now I am doing an out of phase. That middle knob number two. Remember, this volume works only for the bridge pickup. In the middle, bridge pickup is out of the function because volume is turned off. Maximum in phase, minimum out of phase. So when you have out of phase coil with another coil in phase, basically that low dominant frequency, the bass frequency, is like muted a little bit down. That's why you hear much brighter sound, and out of phase, the sound is like you are taking the bass out. So now it's out of phase. In phase. Now let's go get to that last knob, and that's a master tone. It has a position in the middle when you can feel it, that position. When you close that part, it works like a regular tone control on any guitar. It takes off a harmonic frequency, it has a less high frequencies. I touch that tone shifter. When you go with that master tone knob all the way up, you are adding overdrive, like a little bit distortion. So I will play. We are on the position that pickup with a little bit help tuning it to resonant frequency with those two coils. And I will show you how I will add overdrive. So this should be a really nice clean sound. I'm getting overdrive. overdrive added, it's like little bit you want to have like you are, it looks like you are hitting the strings much harder, and you have that natural overdrive. So we did explanation of those three knobs work same way in any position of that toggle switch. The toggle switch is set up to have a two position of the Telecaster sounds and two positions of the Telecaster single coil sounds and two positions of the humbucker sounds. When you are going with the neck and middle, and then position two, bridge and middle, basically this middle pickup is set the magnets. The polarity of magnets are set to the reverse polarity. So when you put those two pickups together in the series, you have an excellent humbucker sound, like PRS, like a Gibson, like any other humbucker pickup. So let me go to position. We'll start it with the neck. So it's position, if I'll say the neck is position 5, I'm going to position 4, those two pickups together. And I'll show you the sound. The sound will be really different. The sound will be like a humbucker. I am going in the middle with the knobs, not adding that knob in, that pickup in. So just neck and middle set in the series without any other corrections. I am adding overdrive. Now you can hear it much better, because we are in the humbucker mode. Clean sound. Overdrive. So we are in the humbucker position, those two pickups. What we can do right now with that tone shifter, we have one unused coil, the bridge pickup coil. So we can choose in which position we want to use that unused bridge pickup coil, and we can add it. So tune it a little bit more. It'll be much louder and sound will be still like humbucker, because we are in the mode number 4, like a humbucker. But right now what we can do in this case, we can have all three pickups in the series, and the bridge pickup we can have in polarity or out of polarity. So let me set it up. So now we have only those two coils. Clean sound. I added this coil in polarity. Out of polarity. You can hear that tone shifter. Now it's without that coil. I added that coil in. Now I'm in the best resonant frequency. Basically, now those three pickups, they are in the resonant frequency. Listen it. It was out of polarity. Now I'm switching this coil into polarity. That humbucker mode. Of course, we still can use the master tone and add a little bit. What we now we have a bridge in polarity, maximum volume, added a little bit bridge, and those two, they are like a humbucker. Basically, we have everything acts like a humbucker right now, because the middle is in the reverse polarity. We have this one, magnets. Magnet out of polarity, in polarity, in polarity. So we have a two coils in polarity, in the series with one coil out of polarity. It's not exactly equal, but it works like a humbucker. This is with the overdrive. Clean. Overdrive. Clean. Overdrive. So let's go switch. I'm going to put it in the middle, clean sound. I'm leaving this coil when we will work with her. In polarity and tone shifter, it's out. The potentiometer volume is on the maximum volume, but no tone shifter. And we are going in the third position. So the third position, in this case, we have only the middle pickup is working. We are in the Stratocaster mode. Sound like single coil strat. We can add again, use the tone knob, master tone knob, add overdrive or cut the high frequencies down. I'm not going to touch it, we didn't explain it, and we will concentrate only on those knobs. So if I want to add this coil in polarity, that bridge coil to the dead pickup, I have to a little bit move that tone shifter. And I am adding that bridge coil into that middle coil. Now it's only middle coil. Maximum middle and bridge. It was in polarity. Bridge is out. Is in out of polarity. Do you hear it? What you can do, just shifting and adding that bridge coil into in polarity middle coil. So I will leave it out of polarity and I will try it on that tone shifter. Oh, you can hear it really nicely right now. Because one coil is in polarity, another one is out again. Now I'm putting in polarity. So, this middle position, position number three, it's Stratocaster mode. Only of one pickup, and to that one pickup with that phase shifter, we can add that neck pickup, like a bass coil, and that bridge pickup, like a in polarity or out of polarity high frequency coil. So I will turn it again completely. Now I am set up for that coil, like a bass, and this one is in and out polarity. Shifter completely open, changing the coils in and out polarity. So basically, we have only toggle switch here. Those parts, they are variable parts. We have unlimited options of the tone controls. I'm just showing you three options. Completely close, middle, completely open, basically. But you can still try figure out some good tone somewhere in the middle of those three options. And it's like unthinkable. You have to be in the another dimension to start thinking about that Stratocaster. So this was position number three. We said that it's single coil and sounds like Stratocaster. We are in the position number two. Right now in that position, when the tone shifter is in the middle, value maximum, those two pickups on the Stratocaster should work. And they are working. We are going to have this coil in polarity with this coil in polarity. But remember, the magnets on this middle pickup are a reverse polarity, but I did offset it with turning the coil too. So everything is in the polarity right now. Those two coils in polarity, no phase, no tone shifter, and polarity, and master tone is clean sound. I am going to add a little bit of the distortion. Going to touch the tone shifter, stays still in the same position in the middle, maximum volume, but I will flip to the out of polarity. So this coil right now, it's out of polarity with that coil. I can hear a little bit minimum of the hum, but those RPEs, revolutionary passive electronics, they are set up like they are backing off the hum even in the reverse polarities. So now we have a last position, to position number one, when the bridge pickup is the master coil. I should mention that I call those pickups all the time like master, and secondary pickups I call them slave, or primary and secondary coils or pickups. So right now we are in the position number one when bridge pickup is master, tone knob is in the clean sound, not phase shifter yet. So you can hear even you say, wow, the bridge pickup should have worked, and it's not working. We are in the position number one. It's not working because we have a designated volume control for the bridge pickup. In polarity, zero volume. Out of polarity, like I said before, you cannot compare right now that bridge pickup with another pickup, so the sound of in and out of polarity is the same. So right now I will move that phase shifter, I will leave it in polarity, clean sound, and I will move that phase shifter from the middle position, from the maximum volume, a little bit up, and you will hear the difference, and we will add those two pickups in. Now, those two pickups, they are working, they are tuning resonant frequency of this bridge pickup, and basically they are helping him do secondary pickups. What they do, the master pickup right now, the bridge pickup makes the sound, and we want to keep on the position number one the sound of the bridge pickup. But those secondary pickups, slave pickups, they are helping, like fighting behind that master pickup, fighting his war and helping him to get that sound much better. So listen it. In polarity, clean sound, only bridge right now. Adding those two anode pickups. Like the tone was shifting, like you are in the studio, and audio engineer is like using equalizers. So basically that's what is it when is it looking for the right resonant frequency of that bridge pickup. Polarity mode. So let me move it back. No tone shifter. We still have a clean sound, and I am going to move that coil out of polarity. Tone shifter is in the middle position, so only bridge pickup is working, and you will not hear any difference. When I will start adding to this bridge out of polarity pickup, two pickups in polarity, you will hear the difference. So basically, because it's out of polarity, you don't hear so much bass. When we will move out of polarity, less bass, less highs. In polarity, more bass. That's what I am doing, shifting that bridge pickup from in polarity to out of polarity with those two pickups. Basically, you can choose after playing with that guitar, after you get it really good, you don't go just to the maximum positions, middle position and minimum position. You can choose any configuration of the tone you like in positions between. Again, we had a tone control in the middle, so it was clean sound. And we can get overdrive.